Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us for our functional overview today. We appreciate you guys dialing in a couple minutes early. We are going to stop at the top of the hour, or we'll start the webinar, the content at the top of the hour. So you have about 2 or 3 minutes if you want to grab a last cup of coffee or settle into a comfortable chair. We'll be starting at 11 o'clock. Thank you. Again, thank you and welcome to everyone for joining us today for the functional overview on purchasing. I'm excited we have Casey here sitting with me, who's going to be our featured presenter today. We're going to start the webinar right at the top of the hour. Casey's got some great content that's going to take us pretty much through the full 45 minutes. So we want to start promptly. So we can let you guys move on to whatever meetings you might have at the top of the hour. So again, thank you for joining us. We have some great stuff to share with you. We hope you enjoy it. All right, by my clock, I'm using, the good old computer at Mannequin here in College Park. I've got 11 o'clock, so we'll go ahead and get started. Again, welcome to the functional overview on purchasing. Before we kind of roll into the content, a few points that I want to make, as you can see on the screen here, 3 points. First is we have enabled the live transcript, if that is something that you would like. Instructions are on the screen for how you can enable that. Second point is we are recording this session. We will make this available on the Elevate website once we get it remediated for accessibility. And lastly, we have enabled the Q&A feature of this webinar. So we encourage you throughout the presentation to please type your questions in. They will roll into our panelists who we have working behind the scenes, and they will be able to provide answers to your questions. We also have time saved at the end of the presentation for some live Q&A, and any questions that we are not able to get to today, we will have your email addresses so that we can follow up with you after the session. Oops. So again, purchasing and Workday. Thank you again for coming. Before we begin, I briefly want to introduce the team that we have with us today. For those of you who haven't attended one, my name is Gabe Bugenhagen. I'm the change management lead on the Elevate program. I've been on the College Park campus for about 15 years, coming from a bunch of different backgrounds, and I was excited to join Elevate about a year and a half ago. We also have helping us today is Karen Diesa. She's our communications lead. So if you have been to the website or subscribed to the Elevator newsletter, she is the person that's responsible for all of that content. For today's session, she will be moderating the Q&A in the background and supporting our panelists to get answers to your questions. Next, we have Tatiana Tungsevan, and she recently joined our team as a training specialist. And one of the key areas that she's going to be supporting for training materials is some of the FIN related topics, specifically this purchasing. So when you attend training next year, Tatiana is the one who's supporting that content. And last but not least, we have Karen Contreras-Cruz, or as we like to call her, Casey, and she is our featured speaker today. If you want to learn more about Karen or Casey, you can read our July newsletter. She was actually the employee that we spotlighted. And so there's a little bit more of her bio in that. So that's our team. What are functional overviews? So for those of you that have never attended, we've done six of these so far. So this is our seventh functional overview. I just want to highlight briefly a couple things. First, these are open to everybody. We try to build this content for anyone that wants to come in and get a sneak peek of what's going on with Workday with some of the different things. We have sessions planned through early 2023. We do them every month. Usually it's the last Thursday of the month at 11 o'clock. So if you want to put some save the dates, that's our the schedule we shoot for. As I mentioned earlier, we do try to keep these to less than an hour. We target 45 minutes for all the content and the Q&A. And these are optional. You're welcome to attend or not attend, find topics that particularly interest you. But we do encourage you to attend as many as you can, because it is a way to become familiar with Workday and to be aware of what the Elevate program is working on. And lastly, this is a preview of the system. It's not designed to be formal training. Casey is going to do an amazing job, but we don't expect that at the end of this, you're going to be trained and ready to submit shell shock orders or non-catalog orders. This is just a preview of the system. So what's our agenda today? We're going to be going over some of the key terms, the primary roles that are involved with the purchasing process in Workday. KC's also got some great benefits. We also have two demonstrations for you. And for those of you that have attended prior functional overviews, we're making a little tweak to the demo this time, and we're making it full screen. So we hope it's going to be easier for you all to see and hear. So we bear with us as we're trialing this new demo format. We hope you like the change that we've made based on your feedback. Next, Casey will wrap up with some of the what happens next after somebody submits a requisition. And lastly, it'll roll back to me and I will give some ideas or some places that you can go to learn more about the Elevate program. And with that, I'm going to turn it over to Casey. Thanks, Casey.
Thanks, Gay. And again, welcome to everyone who has joined. My name is Casey, and I'm here to share my excitement and knowledge about purchasing in Workday. Purchasing in Workday is going to be a new centralizing tool for all things procurement. Requisitions are designed to be self-service. This means requests or carts can be initiated by any university employee, and workers will be able to create requisitions on behalf of other workers. Users will be able to initiate different requisition types, such as delegated consulting or contract agreements, sole source, competitive, and the most frequently used standard requisition. Once submitted, requisitions will follow a predictable flow for approvals, which includes departmental approval. Approvers will also have access to send back requests, all within the system. Reviewers will be able to send back or correct a requisition. This will be an alternative request process that is not paper or email based. The Maryland Procurement and AP dashboard will be a one-stop shop for requesting goods and services, viewing requisitions, receiving orders, and much more. Today, we will be spotlighting purchase requisitioning in Workday. You can go to the next slide, Gay. Thank you. So let's talk about a few terms related to purchase requisitioning in Workday that may be handy during today's presentation. The first one is purchase requisition. A purchase requisition is a request to purchase goods or services from a supplier. Next, we have a supplier. In Workday, vendors will be known as suppliers, and suppliers are business entities that provide goods and services. Next, we have a punch out. Punch outs are external links to curated sites for contracted suppliers. Catalog requisitions are requisitions associated with shell shop punchouts. Shell shop is currently used by UMCP as their electronic shopping platform, but in Workday, all entities will have access to shell shop. For those who are not familiar, think of shell shop as a collection of catalogs to shop from. We'll dive further into shell shop and its integration with Workday later in the presentation. Non-catalog requisitions are requisitions that are not initiated from a catalog. All of these terms will be added to the Elevate glossary available on our website for future reference. Now we'll want to discuss the roles involved in purchasing in Workday. More specifically, who is responsible for initiating, reviewing, and approving requisitions? Requesters are initiators of purchase requisitions. All employees access the Maryland Procurement and AP dashboard as a requisitioner to create shell shop and non-catalog orders. Cost center procurement managers have an important review step in the requisition process, as they are able to assign the appropriate work tags for each requisition, and they serve as gatekeepers for their organization's business office. Driver work tag managers are requisition approvers who can approve or send back requisitions. They are responsible for keeping costs in line with budgets and tracking expenses for their organizations. So you might be wondering, how can I request goods and services in Workday? Well, there are two main ways to request goods and services in Workday. The first way is through Shell Shop. Shell Shop is currently UMCP's semi-standalone e-commerce platform. But again, all entities will have access to Shell Shop in Workday. With Workday, we'll use what's called a sandwich model for Shell Shop. This means actions will begin and end in Workday, with shopping activities occurring in Shell Shop in the middle of the process. Shell Shop has 19 catalogs for office supplies, technology, scientific, and facility supplies. We're also implementing e-invoicing for Shell Shop catalogs. The second way to request goods and services is through non-catalog orders. In Workday, you'll be able to initiate a non-catalog order, add details about your goods or services, select a supplier, add attachments to your requisition, such as a quote, and submit your requisition for approval. Let's look at the high-level overview of the requisition to PO process. The process starts with a requisition created by a requester. After the requester submits the requisition, it will route to the cost center procurement manager for updates. Cost centers may assign this role to multiple people. Then the requisition will go to the driver work tag manager based on their driver work tag selected. If the requisition includes any goods or services that require specialty approval, such as vehicles, animals, and assets, the system will automatically route those requests to the appropriate group for review and approval. If the requisition is outside of the delegated threshold, the system will route to central procurement for sourcing. Once the requisition is fully approved and sourced, the system will generate a purchase order. After the PO is complete and issued, a receipt may be required. The departments will be able to track the process of their requisitions and POs using reports and the process history on each document. Now I get to share with you some of the key benefits for purchasing in Workday. The first is that Workday is the single point of entry for all requisition activity. With everything in one place, requesting and receiving goods becomes more streamlined and more efficient. All purchase orders and contracts will begin as Workday requisitions. Secondly, we've consolidated some of our commonly used procurement forms and requests to be completed electronically in Workday. This includes sole source documentation and delegated contract review. We've also automated specialty review steps for trackable purchases, such as vehicles and assets. Another is that Workday gives you visibility of the status of your requisition. You can see where in the process your requisition is by viewing the process history, which will show actions in progress and or completed by an approver. We'll see this later in the demo. Lastly, Workday makes navigating your procurement needs easier with the inclusion of help text, validations, and guided tours to help employees fill out the requisition accurately. There are more benefits that you will learn about during future training sessions. Now that we've seen the requisition to PO process and discussed the ways you can request goods and services in Workday, let's take a deeper dive on how Shell Shop will fit into the process. For the first demonstration, we want to show you how to use Workday as a current employee to create a Shell Shop requisition. we'll see this high-level process flow in action. You'll locate ShellShop and enter requisition details. Then you'll create a shopping cart in ShellShop. You'll continue through the checkout process until you complete and submit your requisition in Workday. We'll fast forward through the approval process to show you how to view the status of your requisition. And don't worry, approvers, there will be future training where we will show you your actions and show it all from your view. You'll also get to see the Maryland Procurement and AP dashboard in Workday. This is where users can find centralized access to procurement tools, such as finding their requisitions, purchase orders, accessing ShellShop, and reports all from within the dashboard. In this demo, we'll be acting as Erica employee, who will be submitting a ShellShop requisition for her department. Now let's jump into the first demo.
Welcome to the Workday Purchase Requisition Demonstration, where we will requisition a ShellShop order. I have logged in as a typical employee, Erica employee, in the Workday training environment. Erica needs to purchase a keyboard and computer mouse for her department's front office. We can use ShellShop for that. What is ShellShop? ShellShop is currently used by UMCP as their electronic shopping platform. But when we move to Workday, all entities will have access to ShellShop. For those who are not familiar, think of ShellShop as a collection of catalogs to shop from. This sounds great. So, how do we get there? There are two ways to start a requisition. The first way is by using the search bar on the Workday homepage. You can type Create Requisition to access the Create Requisition Task page. The second way is by accessing the Maryland Procurement and AP app. From the homepage, I'll click View All Apps. Then I'll click Maryland Procurement and AP. Erica is now viewing her Maryland Procurement and AP dashboard. On this page, you can request goods and services, create a receiving report, view your requisitions, or take actions related to procurement cards if you have a P-card. To start a ShellShop purchase requisition, we'll click Connect to ShellShop. We're taking to the Connect to Supplier website page where we will confirm and enter details and select work tags for this purchase requisition. You can also see there's field level help for this page. Let's click Show Me. By clicking Show Me, Workday provides help text for fields that may need extra clarification. That's helpful. Now let's continue to explore the page. On this page, some fields have default information pre-selected, such as the requester, company, deliver to, and ship to addresses. These prompts can also be modified if needed. For example, if Erica is requisitioning an order on behalf of another employee, she would update the requester field with that employee's name. I see that requisition type is a mandatory field that we must complete. By clicking into the drop-down list, we will see the available options to select: competitive, sole source, standard requisition, and a few more. Erica may need some help determining this one. Thankfully, there's field-level help text. Let's click the help icon that appears next to the requisition type field. After reviewing the options, we'll select Standard Requisition, which is the most frequently used requisition type. Scrolling down, here are some familiar work tags: Grant, GIF, Project, and USource. These are driver work tags that identify the funding source. In this case, they are used to manage expenses. Erica needs to determine if her purchase of a keyboard and computer mouse is related to a grant, a gift, or a project. Because her purchase is not a grant, gift, or project, she'll use the use source work tag. Erica isn't quite sure what to enter here, but good news, Workday makes it easy. Erica can select from available options under My Work Tags. My Work Tags will include the work tags associated with her cost center. She can select an option for it to populate as the use source. Great! We've selected the use source work tag for UMCP's Psych Department. Now that we've selected a use source driver work tag, there's no other mandatory field on this page. So we'll click OK. On this page, you'll see the option to connect to Shell Shop. Let's click Connect to navigate to the Shell Shop catalog page. This is where our shopping experience begins in Shell Shop. The shop page shows the available punch-out catalogs. In the Workday test environment, we have two catalogs, Dell and Grainger. Remember, this is a training environment. There will be more catalogs available in the actual system. With Shell Shop, we can add items from any of these punch-out catalogs, like from Dell. Once you're done shopping, the shopping cart from Shell Shop will transfer over to Workday's shopping cart so we can finish the requisition. Let's walk through it together. We'll click on the Dell punch-out catalog to shop for a computer mouse and keyboard. A pop-up window for Dell displays. Let's use the Dell search to type what we're looking for. Wonderful! We've found a keyboard and mouse combo. This is just what Erica is looking for. Let's add it to our shopping cart by clicking Add to Cart. Great! The item is in our cart. To begin the checkout process, we'll click Create Order Requisition. Then we'll click Continue Securely to advance to the next checkout page. On the checkout page, we'll click Submit Order Requisition. This closes the Dell Punch-Out cart window and moves the items into our Shell Shop cart. We're back to Shell Shop, where here it is. Our item is in the cart. We're done adding items, so let's click Checkout to get back to Workday. Now that we've returned to Workday, you can see the item information has transferred over. Since we are done shopping, we can click Checkout one more time to continue the requisition process. On the checkout page, let's review our requisition information and goods details. There are other fields that can be filled out, like internal memo. Erica has the option to add an internal memo that can be read by the purchase requisition approver. Now that we've scrolled down, we can review and confirm the information in the goods section. Here you'll see that some fields are mandatory because they have the red asterisk next to them. Let's look at spend category. Spend category represents a classification of transaction. Examples include printing and reproduction, audio and visual equipment, construction work, and so much more. Erica is buying office supplies. Let's type office supplies in the drop-down list. Great! Office supplies is a spend category we can use here. You can also confirm the correct work tags have been selected. Scrolling down, we see there is an attachment section. We do not have any attachments to provide, so let's click Submit. The confirmation page shows that our requisition has been submitted. Hooray! Erica has successfully shopped and submitted her purchase requisition for approval. You can click on the Details and Process tab to see more details, including the overall status of the requisition. By selecting the Process tab, we can immediately see where we are in the process, including who is listed as the approver in the process. It looks like we're awaiting action from the person who coordinates procurement for her department, the Cost Center Procurement Manager. Erica is able to check the status of her requisition at any time through the Maryland Procurement and AP dashboard. Let me show you by going back to that dashboard. I'll click Home, View All Apps, Maryland Procurement and AP. To view your requests, we'll click My Requisitions. To better search for results, we can enter selection criteria such as requisition, status, type, supplier, and purchase order to narrow results. You can also just click OK. In the My Requisitions report, Erica will be able to see her requisitions along with the requisition details and their status. For example, because Erica's requisition is still in progress and has not been approved, you can see that we still have the option of editing the requisition. If the requisition is fully approved, she'll see a status of successfully completed, along with a link to the associated purchase order. Clicking on the purchase order link allows you to view the PO and its status now that it's been routed to procurement. Well, Erica, we can't wait to hear about the new keyboard and mouse you got for your department. We hope through this example, you learned more about creating Shell Shop purchase requisitions in Workday and how to view the status of your requisitions after creating them. Thanks for watching.
All right, now let's check out the process flow and creation of non-catalog requisitions. For the last demonstration, we want to show you how to use Workday to create a non-catalog requisition. In this demo, we'll tag along with Erica employee as she requisitions an equipment repair using a non-catalog requisition. We'll see this high-level process flow in action. You'll initiate the process by using the Workday search bar to search for create requisition task. This is another way to begin a requisition. You'll select whether you are requisitioning goods or services, then enter the details for your requisition, such as a supplier and maybe attachments as needed. Again, we'll fast forward through the approval process for this demonstration and talk about what happens after your PO is ready. Now let's jump into that second demo.
For this Workday purchase requisition demonstration, we will requisition a non-catalog order. What do we mean by non-catalog? A non-catalog requisition is used when an order is not included in the standard catalog of items, in this case, Shell Shop. Don't worry, Workday makes it easy to place different types of order requisitions all in one place. Let's get started. I have logged in as Erica employee in the Workday training environment. Erica needs to requisition an equipment repair service for a research lab in her department. She can use the non-catalog order for this. To get started with creating Erica's purchase requisition, we will use the search bar at the top of the Workday homepage. The search bar is a fast way to locate business processes, tasks, and reports, and so much more in Workday. Let's type Create Requisition in the search bar and select the Create Requisition task from the results. Great! We are taken to the Create Requisition page. On this page, there are default selections for requester, company, deliver to, and ship to addresses that you can modify if ever needed. You will also select your requisition type and driver work tag to classify your order. Let's get to it. By clicking into the drop-down list, we will see the available options to select. We'll select Standard Requisition to classify Erica's requisition type. Remember, whenever you see a question mark icon, that means there's field level help available. Scrolling down, here are some familiar work tags: grant, gift, project, and use source. Erica determined that the equipment repair service she is requisitioning is related to a use source work tag. Let's click the use source field. By selecting My Work Tags in the Use Source field, we can choose from available options that will include the work tags associated with Erica's cost center. The Use Source work tag for Erica's cost center with the UMCP Psych Department shows up here. Let's select it. We've entered all the necessary information on this page to start the requisition. Let's click OK. We're taken to the Create Requisition page that includes some instructions and the option to request goods or services by either connecting to Shell Shop or by requesting non-catalog items. We will click Request Non-Catalog Items. On the Request Non-Catalog Items page, first, we will select whether we are requesting goods or services. In this case, Erica is requisitioning an equipment repair service for a research lab in her department. So we will select Request Service. Great! The page has updated with fields related to services. And now we can enter service request details, such as description, spend category, supplier information, and cost. You can see that description and spend category are mandatory fields because they have the red asterisk. Let's complete those fields. In the description field, we'll type a description of the service. Next, we'll select the spend category. Spend category represents a classification of spent transactions. By typing keywords in the spend category field, we can narrow results in order to find the right one. Let's type equipment repair to see what comes up. Wonderful! There is a spend category for equipment maintenance and repair. That's just what Erica needs. Let's click on it. Moving down, here's the supplier field. When requisitioning a non-catalog item, requesters usually know what supplier they are interested in using. In this case, Erica knows the supplier for this requisition is Advanced Equipment Co. Incorporated because she requested a quote for the equipment repair service she is requisitioning. Let's type the supplier name right in the supplier field and hit enter. Excellent. Moving down, here's the extended amount field. Requesters can enter the cost or the quoted amount for service. We'll enter $6,000 in the extended amount field because that's the amount Erica was quoted for the repair service. Excellent, it looks good. We have completed the service request details for this equipment repair service requisition. Let's click Add to Cart. If we wanted to add more goods or services, we could do so on this page. Erica is ready to continue, so we can click the cart icon at the top of the page to check out. On the Workday checkout page, we can see that everything we put in the cart has been added to this requisition. Let's review the requisition information before we submit for approval. You can use the Memo to Supplier field to reference a quote from a supplier. Let's type quote number 9997 here. In addition, we can use Internal Memo to provide more information to our Cost Center Procurement Manager. In this case, we'll add for the Attention and Memory Psych Lab. Scrolling down to the Services section, you can review the selection and entry details by scrolling to the right. At the bottom of the page, we have the Attachments section to include attachments related to the non-catalog requisition. You can open the attachment section to drop or select files. What's a good example of an attachment? Well, Erica received a quote from the supplier for the equipment repair requisition. Let's add the quote file here to include in this requisition. You can also add a comment that is related to the attachment for the requisition approvers to view. Great! We've included all the information we need to submit our non-catalog requisition. Let's click Submit. The confirmation display is telling us that we have submitted the requisition. Hooray! From here, the requisition will route through the approval process. Erica is able to view her requisitions and their statuses by searching My Requisitions in the search bar, or by going to the Maryland Procurement and AP app. Once the PO is finalized, you'll receive a system notification on what to do next. In this demo, we have shown you how to create a non-catalog purchase requisition. Thanks for watching.
Now that we've shown you how to create a requisition in Workday, you're probably wondering what happens when your PO is ready. There are two steps that take place after a PO is ready that I want to highlight here. The first is that once a purchase requisition has been approved and the PO has been generated, the PO needs to be issued to become available for invoicing. In Workday, suppliers can have one of three issue options assigned that determine how the PO is communicated with the supplier. For POs initiated from Shell Shop catalogs, Workday will automatically send PO information to the supplier through Shell Shop. No action will be needed by the requester, but they will receive a notification of the dispatch. For non-catalog suppliers, Workday will issue the PO via email if we have an email address on the supplier's record, and requesters will receive a notification of the dispatch. Otherwise, requesters and cost center procurement managers will receive a notification to let them know to dispatch the PO manually. The PDF copy of the PO will always be available on the associated purchase order within Workday. The second step I want to highlight is receipt creation. Receipts will be required for all UMES purchase orders and purchase orders over 25,000 for UMCP, UMCs, USMO, and Shady Grove. For POs that require a receipt, the requester or the cost center procurement manager should complete the receipt prior to invoicing. For UMES, Central Receiving will create receipts in Workday. That covers at a high level what happens next. Let me turn it back to Gay so we can talk about what we can learn more and our Q&A.
Awesome, Casey. Thank you so much for that. We're coming up on time here, so I'm going to be really brief. Where you can start, the Elevate website. That's the best place that I can point you. We have, as you see on the slide here, resources that we have. Two call outs that I briefly want to mention here are the Elevator newsletter. You can subscribe through there. You can also see prior issues. We now generate the newsletter every month. It usually comes out on the last Tuesday of the month. So please subscribe if you haven't already. And the second quick call out here is the news and events. And that's where you can find out about events that we have upcoming, like our fall semester town hall, future functional overviews, things of that nature. And it's also where we post any recordings from any prior event. So I know you guys want to get to the Q&A, and I want to make sure we leave enough time. So that's the key points on the where to start if you have more questions about the Elevate program.
Hi, everybody. I am just going to run a poll really quick for everyone on this webinar. We just want to hear from you all about how your experience was today. And then while I let this run and you start to answer these poll questions, I can get started on some Q&A with KC because we don't have that much time left. But I do also want to mention that our panelists have been answering questions in the Q&A feature on webinar this whole time. And a lot of those questions are actually visible to you if you go to the Q&A box. So if you want to just peruse, feel free. But one question that we got that I wanted to ask KC is, can requisitions be sent back for revision at any level? Currently in KFS, they're just disapproved and have to be recreated.
Yeah, that's actually a great question. So the send back button is available for the cost center, procurement manager, and every approver after that. And when one of the approvers sends back the requisition, the system will prompt for a note to let them know what needs to be updated. And the requisition can be sent back to any previous step for updates.
Great. Mm-hmm. Okay. Another question that we get this question a lot, but just to reiterate, some people were asking if the demos will be available for viewing after this session, especially with these demos. I feel like there was a lot thrown at everyone during this session, which is good, but I could see why someone would want to revisit those. So yeah, we do post the demos alone by themselves outside of this webinar on our website, and we send them to everyone after this session via email, and we also post them to our YouTube channel. We do have a YouTube channel, so you'll be able to watch these. You can put them on your TV if you want to. Another question I have for KC is, will campuses other than College Park, I know we mentioned Shell Shop and how it was UMCP's catalog ordering system, will other entities have access to Shell Shop in Workday?
Yes, so we worked with our Shell Shop provider, ESM Solutions, to give access to the rest of the partner entities that will be in Workday. So everyone will have access to the same Shell Shop.
Great. Mm-hmm. One question that one of our panelists answered earlier that I wanted to kind of bring up for the group is that someone asked, Lisa Amick actually, hi Lisa, asked, departments currently have to authorize Shell Shop users. Will that continue to happen with Workday? The answer to that is that all employees will have the permissions necessary to enter Shell Shop, but once requests are created, they'll route to the department's cost center procurement manager as the first step. Users can also create Shell Shop requisitions on behalf of other users if that employee prefers not to use Shell Shop themselves. I don't know, Casey, if you have anything to add, I think.
No, that was perfect.
Okay, great. another question I have for Casey is it preferred to have the supplier contract entered if it is known?
Yes, with Workday, it'll be a little easier to find them. The Workday field for supplier contract only pops up if the supplier actually has a contract, and it only shows you the contracts that are for that supplier. So it's a lot easier to find them, and it's a searchable field. So yes, you should use them.
Great. And then another question that came in, I think this is just people thinking about the transition to Workday. Someone asked, for open POs that have annual renewals, will they be transferred into Workday with the same PO number, or will a new PO need to be created?
That's a great question. Yes, the POs are being converted with the KFS PO number so that we don't have to make any changes with our suppliers. We are converting purchase orders that are open and have remaining obligations on them. So now would be a great time to take a look at your open POs. And if they're not supposed to be open, close them. If they are supposed to be open, you don't need to do anything else.
And then I think this is probably going to be our last question that we address to the whole group. I know that there are a lot of questions that came in through the Q&A, and I think there are still some open ones now. Just know that we have your email information, and we can follow up with you if your question is not addressed during this session. But thank you all so much for your engagement, because we've got some really great questions in the back end. So Casey, what is the maximum number of items Workday is allowing in a regular PO?
Workday doesn't have any restrictions for the maximum number of items, but there does come a point where a PO can become a little difficult to work with once it gets too big. So I wouldn't recommend it, but no restrictions technically by Workday.
Great. Okay, with that, I think it's 11:44. I want to be respectful of everyone's time, so I'm going to turn it back over to Gay to close this out.
Awesome. Thanks, guys. Casey, fantastic information. Thanks for sharing it with all of us. I know I learned a few new things today as well. Again, reiterate, as Karen just mentioned, we've been triaging your questions in the background. We have your contact information to ping you back once we have answers to your questions. Again, reiterate that the recording of this full session, as well as the isolated two demonstrations that we showed, will be available on the website. You'll be notified as soon as they are remediated for accessibility and posted to our website and our YouTube channel. So subscribe to the YouTube channel. So lastly, and in closing, on behalf of myself, Casey, Karen, Tatiana, and our team of panelists that have been working in the background and the entire Elevate program, we thank you for attending today, and we look forward to having you at future sessions. Have a great day.